Everyone should get a picture with her tonight. That was a great speech by Hannah. That was very beautiful and touching. Cool. I can get my prickly humid paper out. But hello, everyone. For those who don't know who I am, I'm Steve Fabian, the younger brother of Tyler. And for those who don't know Tyler too well, well, I hope this speech gives you an idea of who Tyler is and what kind of person or how he's impacted my life. But first, let me get into my first memory of these two lovebirds. It was January 2012, nice and cold. Ooh. As Father Peter mentioned in his homily, which was beautiful, by the way. You can clap for Father Peter. It was great, right? It was great. So it was January, I believe, 2012, right? Okay, I got an acknowledgement. And Julia came over to our house shortly after the new year. And I could tell the moment she was interested in Tyler, whether she'll admit it or not, is that when she committed to playing to a game of street hockey in our driveway. It was incredible. I was like, this is the one. But being the younger brother of Tyler carries enormous expectations. Tyler's been always my number one guy, and he's someone I could always rely on no matter what. Tyler's essentially the glue in everything he was a part of. He kept everyone together, working as a team, whether it was out in the athletic field or in the church, helping others grow in their faith. He is someone that is always willing to serve others, his community, and the Lord. Tyler, do you remember the good old days? Remember the good old days, man? 10, 11, 12, running around like crazy in the front yard. A great quote that I heard from a TV show called The Office: I wish there was a way to know that you were in the good old days before you left them. Remember when we would spray paint the backyard to make a football field with Dad, spray paint our name in the end zones, Tyler and Steven? Or we'd run football rounds in the street doing hurry up offense since we had 10 seconds left on the clock, and if I dropped the pass or you had a horrible, you know, pass or whatever, we'd start all the way back over and do the whole thing again for whatever reason. Or the times where we would chalk up the driveway basketball court, put on our knee high socks, play hours of the game 21, or first one to 100 points wins. Remember those? Shake your head. There you go. Playing soccer in the backyard, setting up the nets, practicing banging the ball and other, you know, banging the ball around trees and other objects in the backyard. Or Dad would come home with sporting equipment from the dumpster at school and be like, throwing this stuff out. What the heck? What's going on? True. You're like, this is crazy. This is Christmas. Christmas in July. It was always a competition between us. We always had the drive to beat one another, and rarely did it ever end in us pegging the ball or one of us chasing each other around the house before one of us would pray in the house saying we beat each other. Occasionally, it would end in one of us call best out of three or win by two. We always were competing against one another, and this friendly competition between us sparked an amazing relationship. Even though we'd always try to beat each other in the sporting world, outside of it, we'd always be encouraging and helpful to one another when it came to school, relationships, life, and each other's faith. Now that you're moving on to another chapter in your life, I know without a doubt that we can continue to develop an amazing relationship with Julia and be supportive to her. Tyler, you've always been there for me, and I know you'll do the same for Julia. You're a gentleman, a husband, a scholar, a coach, a brother, and most importantly, a man of faith. Let me congratulate both of you on this beautiful sacrament, and let's all raise our glasses to Tyler and Julia, Fabian.